Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. Welcome to Swa Education, myself Radha. And today we are going to discuss about meat, fish and poultry technology. And this lecture is mainly beneficial for the aspirant who are going to prepare for Telangana Food Safety Officer exam. So we already discussed this portion from here to here. And today we are going to target this portion. So meat is an animal flesh mammalian species used very worldwide depending on cultural or religious preference. Meat quality is normally defined by the compositional quality and the palatability factors such as visual appearance, smell, juiciness, tenderness and flavor. So meat, use of meat varies worldwide. It depends on cultural or religious preference. Perception of meat quality by consumer. Intrinsic, at point of scale. First one is the color. Purple and red color are natural for fresh meat. Fatness, fresh meat has white and a bit of yellow fat. Except old beef meat, its fat look yellow. Drip loss, meat with high drip loss has an unattractive appearance, lead to poor color, low consumer acceptance, loss of sale, and nutritional quality. Mainly these are the source of protein. So these are the perception of meat quality by the consumer. On cooking, perception of consumer of meat quality on cooking, mainly aroma, shrinkage, exudates, on eating tenderness, flavor. So which factor affect meat quality? Muscle location, feeding, temperature, humidity and water activity. Mainly these factors are responsible to affect the meat quality. Effect of age on meat quality. How age can affect quality of a meat? Animal aging causes darkening of meat. As animal aged, meat can convert into dark color, and tenderness is also greatly affected by age. Less tender as the animal age, more tender as the animal is young one. Meat flavor also intensifies with age. Flavor meat of older animal, especially sheep, may be so intense that some find it to be objectionable. So flavor and tender, these are mainly affected by the age of the animal. So that's how they can affect the quality of meat. Effect of feeding on meat quality. Starchy food and sugar feed before slaughter can help restore depleted muscle glycogen level to allow development of a normal postmortem pH. So starchy food and sugar feed before slaughter, it affect on meat quality. Grass contain high level of beta carotene, which can be stored in fat, giving the fat a yellow color. So beta carotene is mainly responsible to give a yellow color. An undesirable greasy flavor may result from compound found in forage. Consumption of wild onion and garlic also give an undesirable meat flavor. If these are consumed by the animal, so that's how the flavor of meat also change. So that's how feeding affect on meat quality. Animals should not be allowed to forage for several weeks. Foraging means to finding out the food. So animals should not be allowed to forage for several weeks before slaughtering. Instead, they should be fed a grain diet. Effect of pH decline on meat quality. How pH affect on meat quality? pH decline. Rate at which the carcass pH level fall from 7.10 to the level at which it will not fall any further. If the pH decline is too fast, the ultimate level is reached while the temperature is still high and heat shortening will result. So pH decline affect the quality of meat as well. effect of thaw rigor and cold shortening on meat quality. When meat is frozen before the onset of rigor mortis, a more severe form of rigor mortis will set in upon thawing the meat. This is called thaw rigor. Due to thaw rigor, meat is very tough and lack juiciness. So thaw rigor effect on meat quality, it convert meat into tough meat, soft meat into tough meat. And cold shortening develop when meat is not frozen but is stored between 32 and 59 degree Fahrenheit. It is less severe than thaw rigor. So we can say that thaw rigor is more severe than cold shortening. Next one is the effect of carcass electrical stimulation on meat quality. How it affects on meat quality? So method of improving the tenderness of beef and protect against cold shortening may improve meat tenderness. It reduces aging time. Next one is the effect of water activity on meat quality. Free water available for microbial growth in a food product. What is water activity? Ratio of water vapor pressure measured in the product and the pressure of saturated water vapor atmosphere at the same temperature. So it is the ratio of water vapor measured in product. So water activity is equal to ratio of water vapor pressure measured in product upon water vapor pressure in atmosphere at same temperature. So the minimum moisture content necessary for microbial growth varies with the single species of microorganism. So it varies according to the species of microorganism that how much moisture content is required for the growth of any microorganism and can be expressed in term of minimum water activity required. Keeping quality of dried meat and meat product without refrigeration depend on their water activity. Dried meat such as charcoal etc. reach a slightly low water activity to be shelf life. So they require low water activity. So species to species moisture content differ in case of microorganism. Meat quality attributes. Visual identification. We check that whether texture and tenderness is good or not, smell and taste, color and flavor and aroma. So first one is the tenderness and texture. It depends on several factors like size of meat fiber, activity of muscle, degree of natural aging of animal, mechanical means, enzymatic treatment, kind and distribution of connective tissue. So tenderness and texture depend on these factors. Next one is the smell and taste, or we can say aroma and flavor. So freshness of meat is generally indicated by its smell together with the appearance and color. So by checking the color and by smell, we can observe that either meat is fresh or not. So smell of fresh meat should be slightly acidic. If meat is fresh, its smell is slightly acidic, increasing in relation to the duration of ripening period because of the formation of acid, that is lactic acid. Unpleasant odor owing to substance originate from the bacteria. Next one is the color. Natural color of fresh meat except poultry meat is dark red, caused by the muscle pigment, especially myoglobin. Remarkable change in the meat color occur when fresh meat has been boiled or cooked. So meat color change when fresh meat boiled or cooked. It loses its red color almost entirely after cooking or boiling. Color indicate the type and stage of the treatment to which the meat has been subjected, as well as the stage of freshness of meat. So meat can be stored at 28 to 30 degree Fahrenheit, frozen at 0 degree Fahrenheit, ice crystal development due to temperature fluctuation during freezer storage. Frozen meat products should be packaged in material which prevent the evaporation of moisture and entrance of air. So these are the conditions that are required for the storage of a meat. So there are few facts regarding meat quality. So meat quality is normally defined by the compositional quality and the palatability factor, such as visual appearance, smell, tenderness and flavor. And nutritional quality is related to eating quality as perceived by the consumer. Nutritional quality of meat is objective, yet eating quality as perceived by the consumer is highly subjective. And point to be remembered. So the interior of the muscle will remain purple. Why? Because oxygen cannot penetrate to the center of the meat. In the absence of oxygen, interior area of muscle will remain purple in color. Importance of meat in the diet is as concentrated source of protein. So meat is a source of protein which is not only of high biological value, but its amino acid composition complement that of cereal. Consumption of wild onion and garlic can also give an undesirable meat flavor. After slaughtering, lactic acid buildup in the animal carcass causing a decline in pH or acidic nature. So meat quality is normally defined by the compositional quality and palatability factor. Its appearance, its smell, its tenderness and flavor of the meat. So these are the factors that define the meat quality. And the nutritional quality of meat is objective yet eating quality as perceived by the consumer. So several factors like age, muscle location, diet, post-mortem pH decline, temperature, humidity, water activity, thaw rigor, cold shortening, carcass, electrical stimulation and heat rigor. These are several factors that affect the quality of a meat. So I hope this lecture is very clear to all of you. So thank you so much everyone. If you find this video beneficial for you, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel for more such kind of videos. And if you have any query regarding this lecture, you can comment down below.